Assalamu alaikum. How are you? Good. I don't believe, fine. Can I ask you a small thing, please? Can I ask you, please, to stand up? Not difficult? If I can ask everyone to stand up, please. Okay. Is it possible? Yes, everyone to look this way. Everyone to look this way, please. Turn this way. We are here, very nice people, and we want to do nice things. So can I ask you please to do some good, a little massage to this person in the front of you, like this. Please, 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 make very good massage, please. Now you do the same massage to another person. Two, better massage, better massage. Alright, alright, thank you, thank you. Sit down. Okay. I wanted to make a small task for myself. I want to make the simplest presentation today. Okay? I have not many slides, minimum text. We will just talk with you. I want to share with you what I believe is a good legacy, and I want to share this, what we are doing. So my topic is global actions for worldwide legacy. Can you please raise your hand who wants to know worldwide legacy? Who wants to leave legacy for the whole world? Everyone can enjoy. Thank you. So, just a couple words about me. In my country, I have been the advisor for four presidents in my country. And I'm working now in many sectors. We opened a corporation which is working, organizing many events in my country. We have invested into education, in consulting, in marketing, in PR management, in IT companies. And this is going quite well, and I'd like to share why we are doing this. So overall, I believe it's not only in my country, Kyrgyzstan, between Russia and China, Kyrgyzstan, we have the crisis, but we have the crisis all around the world. We have the poverty, we know, we have the school shootings, we have the hunger, we have many people in drugs, narcotics, alcohol, we have many things. But to solve these problems, we need to work together. We understand this. And we chose our target audience, who we affect, who we try to work, is young people. And for young people, why? Because we know future is the youth. We know that it's easier to change young people. They are very energetic, they are active careers. If you teach them good things, they will continue doing good things. And they are convenient for messaging and they are creative. When I say young people, I say all people who feel young. So I believe how you made massage very well, I think everyone is young here. Yes? So we are now working very much with the youth, and the problem with the youth, I say, tell me you agree or you don't agree. When we give youth education, we give them good skills, we give them good sports, but we don't give them good qualities, good values, then we are preparing very dangerous people for the future. We are preparing very dangerous threats to the society. Because all people who are doing bad things, like drug dealers, like prostitution houses, alcohol production, which are very bad politicians, or money laundering, financial schemes, all bad things are being done by very smart people. Right? Do you agree with this?
Yes.
When we give them good education, we give them good skills, but we don't give them good qualities, that's the problem we end up with. And we believe that it's one of the problems that is not being addressed. It's one of the problems that is not being solved. And we have been trying, and we have good progress in solving this. What are we doing? We split our suggestions into four sectors. This is financial sustainability of the NGOs. I believe all of us need this in the all NGOs we're working. We want openness in cooperation with many other institutions, many other organizations, many other countries, not limited to one country or one organization. Third, we want people who have these good qualities to be the leaders in the society. And fourth, we want to use the best Kaizen systems, the best management systems for the NGOs. Before today, all of the Kaizen instruments have been very well used in Toyota production, in Ford companies, in the top Fortune companies, all money-making companies it's been used. We are saying we must use the best management systems for the non-profit sector as well, for the non-governmental sector as well. For that, what we created is a simple system where we have opened, on one hand, on the blue side, a corporation which generates money and works for the improvement of the society. We have, as I mentioned earlier, we have the schools, we have the marketing agencies, we have the IT companies, consulting company, TV radio channels, all of them are producing good values plus generating good money. And this money is spent on the right side, Universal Human Values Foundation. For the Universal Human Values Foundation, where we have a large countrywide youth movement, we have the training center for the youth to teach them to improve their good qualities and to spread good qualities. As well, we have the Islamic centers, because we say universal human values are part of Islam. You agree with me? Because regardless if it's like as a Muslim, I am trying to help other young people so they don't steal, they don't kill others, they don't hurt others, that they help others, that they are humane, that they are nice of culture. At the same time, the whole world, other non-Muslim, also are teaching these qualities. So I say openness, remember folk, openness combines these qualities, that the Muslims and the non-Muslims can work together to improve the society. But my intention here is to make dawah, tabligh. But the other person, non-Muslims, his intention is to help the society. I say we must be friends. I say we must work together, join forces. So that's why we have the Islamic centers. And as a result, what we get is the main element, the system that I'm explaining, for sustainable long-term changes and transformations of the society. It's bringing to that. For, as a result, we get creative, intelligent, healthy young, and caring, good youth with core values. I say that it's a system that generates this, where you have a lot of money generated by investment, and you have good institutions who are funding each other. So this is my result that I want to reach, which we have gone very good in my country, Kyrgyzstan, and I have made intention with my team, with my friends, with my colleagues, that we want to do this in all other countries as well. So as a result, today the Bahrain is my 39th country I'm visiting. I will be visiting after this to Saudi Arabia, India, USA, and China, and after the coronavirus, of course. But I have applied for visa, but I'm waiting until the virus situation is over. But I say we must help them too, right? In China or other countries. So I'm calling my dear participants, if anyone is interested that you want to implement similar projects in your countries, I'll be more than welcome to help and to work with you, to cooperate with you. Because as in the first slide I was saying, we must work together with the good intentions, good projects, good system, so that we can reach. So tell me, who wants this kind of result in your country? Can you raise your hand? If you want this kind of result in your country. Wonderful.
And you have 2 minutes.
I'm finished. So I'm saying it's the system is open for everyone. It's a harmony and synergy generation. It's a functioning globally and fully self-sustainable. Worldwide legacy. Thank you.
Okay, thanks a lot. So translation, please.
ينادي البحث بجهود عالمية جديدة تحدث نغمة موعية في العالم وتحدث أثراً حقيقياً في تحول الإنسانية ويتطرق إلى كيف أننا نعيش اليوم في نزاعات مستمرة وهنالك الكثير من الأزمات والحروب والصراعات والكراهية والتعصب ومن الضروري إيجاد منهجية تقوم على التركيز على أوجه التشابه والأهداف المشتركة بدلاً من الاختلافات والأهداف المتنوعة يراجع الباحث القيم الإنسانية العالمية وأساس الإجراءات الموحدة والعرض الشامل للمؤمنين وغير المؤمنين بغض النظر عن الدين أو الجنس أو الرأي السياسي أو الجنسية. عندما نقوم بتثقيف وتطوير مهارات الشباب مع أطفال القيادة.